Hi, I'm Denise Smeets, and I would like to welcome you to this painting episode by We Love Art. Without any painting experience, you are able to step in the shoes of the real masters, get creative, and recreate art that everyone will recognize. And that all while being in the comfort of your own home. Roy Lichtenstein, born in 1923, is one of the most famous pop art painters in the world. He uses mainly the primary colors, red, blue, yellow, and of course the Bente dot. These dots weren't painted one by one with a very steady hand. No, he used stencils with perforated dot patterns so he could get the perfect circles. Let's roll up the sleeves and let's get going. The beauty is though, it's all primary colors. So it's all like pure reds, blues and yellows. So there's not much mixing here to do. So that makes it slightly easier again. I have used my big brush because I feel comfortable with that one. If you feel more comfortable with a medium brush, then that's fine as well. So I'm just gonna move on to the buildings. The buildings, I'll start first with giving it a black undertone, so black, completely black. Once that's dry, I put on white, and once that's dry, I'll put on the little windows. What I'll do is, I'm putting a little bit of yellow. So yellow, scoop it here to the middle. Yellow and a tiny bit of white, tiny bit, not much. The white makes sure that the paint becomes a bit more opaque, so it covers it better. And I know we're still warming up, but I hope you're warmed up now with these colors and that you're ready to tackle these black lines. We dilute it a little bit with water, a little bit, not too much, just a little bit. So it's kind of runny and nice because it's gonna cover anyway. It's really important to have the palm of your hand resting onto the canvas. This will give maximum support and this makes sure that you're not gonna shake too much. So here, like this. For me, that's the exact thing what I love about painting, you know? Like, you're so absorbed in the moment. It's like uninterrupted time. And you know, when do you still get that? Okay, so for the normal facial color, it's really important that we mix a lot of the same tones. Pop art is all about big color blocks, basically. So it's just all the exact same. So there's no shadowing, no shading, no highlighting, everything like that. No, it's just one big block color. Most of my white. Again, we don't need to make it textured. You know, the pop art is all quite flat. So it's all flat paint, so it's not very textured as what you would see with other styles. Take a bit of brown, I scoop it into the white until I get like some sort of a beige color. Maybe a bit more. I am gonna exaggerate a little bit on the pink side. Now I'm gonna scoop in some red. I'm always careful in my approach, rather underdo it than overdo it. Apply the paint nice and easy over her face. Stroke direction is important. We're not just gonna go like this. We are gonna still follow the shape of her face. Pretend as if you put like moisturizer like this on your face. This is the way how we're gonna treat the strokes. So for her iris, so her color of the eye it's kind of bluish, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tone it down a little bit. If I say tone down, it means I'm gonna add in a tiny bit of gray, just to take the brightness away. So now we are in stage 4. We are gonna do the hair, so the base of the hair. We will take all the yellow, scoop it here in the middle, scoop it in the middle. And now we add a little bit of white, not much. We're gonna just fill everything here with white. So the jacket is white, the glove is white, and this top bubble is white as well. So super easy. Now we're gonna dilute the black again with water, and everywhere basically you're gonna add the outline. I hope you're happy with your interpretation today, and I hope to see you very soon. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.